One of the things about meditation practice is that the situation will never be perfect. There will always be disturbances coming from the outside or coming from within. And the trick to make the meditation work is to learn that this is the way it will always be. The world is out of control. And when you get that, you will just allow things to be the way they are, to go with the flow, not to allow anything external to interrupt your meditation. This is what you can expect from external phenomena. Let it be. Let it go. Just go with the flow. Don't leave an imprint in your mind from external things. And then the mindfulness will gradually become stronger as a consequence. And as you practice in this way, it is as if you are detaching a little bit from the world, as if the world is kind of at arm's length, a certain distance from you. And as you get this feeling of detachment, it becomes so much easier to just to be a passive observer. And remember that beautiful simile of being like a passenger on the train. You're just observing what is in the window, but you have no control over what is going on. Your job is to be aware and not control. And this is a very good simile for the meditation practice. So just sit back and be aware without involvement. And as you do that, gradually the clarity will arise. And sometimes when you let go of the thinking mind and all the activity, you find your mind goes into dullness instead. And if you see that happening, try to use some kind of inspirational thought, something to lift yourself up, to make you feel more joyful and happy. The fact that you are able to be here at the BGF, the fact that you are in the presence of the Buddha, the presence of the Buddha's teachings, these remarkable spiritual teachings that have the ability to lift you up out of your ordinary existence into something far more profitable. And what a wonderful and amazing thing that is. And when you reflect in this way, it draws you out of the dullness, makes you inspired, and it feeds your meditation in a positive way. So make sure you guide your meditation very gently, not by force, not by willpower, but by gently nudging your mind in the right direction. It is all about being gentle to yourself. We are all such sensitive human beings. Gentleness is always the best way. And when the mind is eventually nice and relaxed, nice and easy, and you have a positive mental frame, and you're feeling really good about just sitting there, that is often the right time to gradually move on to the breath. Never go to the breath too soon. Take a long time before you get there to make sure the mind is ready. And then when the mind is ready, it is easy to follow the breath. No need to use any willpower, just a relaxed observation, like a friend. You and this friend of yours, the breath, moving on in stillness, in samadhi. Make it gentle, make it easy. And if you're not ready, don't go there. Just keep on just being still and peaceful until the mind eventually gets to the right point. So once again, coming close to the end. So as we come to the end, once again, review what has happened in the meditation and try to understand the development of the perception and the path of letting go and how it all comes together, how it happens. Just take a moment to reflect on that. Okay, so that's the end of the meditation for now.